actually is, I just don't need to work it through. Joseph James? Now, look, I mean, I'm putting the dollars perfect everybody I can, but he don't want to go nowhere. Why is that? Now, I'm missing a little bit. Are you sure? Please tell me one more time. What's the boy, all right? What's the boy? What's the boy, you know?
God forgive us. He helped us along the way. But, and so now, since we learned, now we are leading. But we expect you to lead. We expect you to lead. You to lead or follow. And because you're in the church, that means you have the capacity and the ability to lead. All of you are leaders in your own life. And you can be leaders. From the youngest all the way up to the oldest. We expect to be leaders. Leading somebody to what? To Christ. Leading somebody to what? To a better life. Leading somebody to what? To improve their life. Job 36, verse 11. Job 36, verse 11 says, if you obey him and serve him, you will spend your days in prosperity and your years in pleasure. Now, when we talk about prosperity, we're talking about whole life prosperity. We're talking about the point to whereby your whole being is prosperous. In other words, not just material. That's part of it. Don't kick that out. But we're talking about your prosperity, your health. Because when you learn the scripture that healing is yours, when you learn the scripture that God promises to protect you, when you learn the scripture and you have it, you can lead somebody else out of captivity. You can lead them out of captivity because in the whole Hosea 4 and 6 says, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. All because we don't know. That's why learning is so important. Once we know, then we begin to lead people. And once we lead people, now we become obedient to the command of God. The command in Matthew 28, verse 19 says, go into all the world and make disciples. In other words, it becomes our responsibility to be obedient to that command.